Hello friends, this is Seher from Easy Peasy, and the topic that we are going to discuss today is called as glycoproteins. Glycoprotein is a combination of two different words. The word glyco comes from glycans, and glycan is a type of carbohydrate. Carbohydrate is one of the major biomolecules of our cell. The second part is proteins, which is another major biomolecule of our cell. So when carbohydrate is going to join itself with proteins, they will be called as glycoproteins. In glycoproteins, oligosaccharides covalently attach themselves with the polypeptide chain. The most common amino acids that are involved in the attachment are serine, threonine, and asparagine. The amount of saccharide that are attached to given polypeptide chain can vary from as little as few percentage to more than 60% by weight. The most common location of the attachment of glycoprotein is endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi complex. From there, they can either go into the lysosomes or go towards the cell surface. Depending on the different type of amino acid involved in the attachment of glycans, we can differentiate them into two different categories. If the oligosaccharide is going to attach itself with asparagine amino acid, then they will be called as N-linked glycans. As you can see in this molecule, the amino group present on asparagine is directly linked in the attachment of this oligosaccharide with it. And if this oligosaccharide is going to attach itself with serine or threonine, then these type of attachment is called as O-linked glycans. As you can see that the OH of serine and threonine is directly attached with glycans here. N-linked glycans are usually seen in highly branched complex structures, and N-linked glycosylation usually occurs in endoplasmic reticulum. On the other hand, O-linked glycosylation usually done by Golgi complex there. These glycans, when they are going to attach themselves with protein, they usually stabilize the structure of that protein. They can also help in the prevention of degradation of that protein by proteases. They can also control the physical maintenance of tissue structure and integrity. And as mostly they are present on the surface of the cell, they can help in cell recognition, receptor ligand binding, and cellular adhesion. That's it for now. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like it, please subscribe this channel. Thank you. Bye-bye.